Is so
reading from Biafra's Got Talent.
Africans will never be free until Biafra comes here. Africans will never be free until Biafra comes here. Africans will never be free until Biafra comes here. Africans will never be free until Biafra comes here. Englishman knows that, Frenchman knows that, Nigeria knows that. Oh. Englishman knows that, Frenchman knows that, Nigeria knows that. Playing on your intelligence, life full of pretense. They are playing on your intelligence. They are playing on your intelligence. Their life full of pretense. Everything is diligent. Oh. Stand up for your. So every black man, so every black man, so you're right. Freedom for Africa, Africa, freedom for Africa. Africans should never be free until Biafra comes here. Africans should never be free until Biafra comes here. Africans will never be free until Biafra comes here. Africans will never be free until Biafra comes here. Englishman knows that. Frenchman knows that. Nigeria knows that. Englishman knows that. Frenchman knows that. Nigerian knows that.
We have been in this bondage for decades now. Oh,
for decades now.
They gave us their culture. They killed our prophets. They colonized our people. With guns and bullets,
guns and bullets.
Biafra is our hope now.
Is our hope now.
Biafra is the hope of Africa.
So every black man stand up for your rights. Wherever you are, stand up for Africa. So every black man stand up for your rights. Freedom for Africa, Africa, freedom for Africa. Africans should never be free until Biafra comes here. Africans should never be free until Biafra comes here. Africans should never be free until Biafra comes here. Africans will never be free until Biafra comes here. Englishman knows that.
Englishman knows that.
Frenchman knows that.
Frenchman knows that.
Nigeria knows that. Englishman knows that. Frenchman knows that.
See them bad men working tirelessly day and night, trying to oppress and bring Jaja children down. So every black man, even now, for the heroes to be, stand up for your right and let us free Africa. I know that Jaja will let us down. You give us Biafra, a golden crown. Africa will rise and be great again. We've had enough of these tears and pain.
So every black man stand. So every black man, for your right, wherever you are, stand up for your Africa. So every black man, stand up for your right, for your right, freedom for Africa, Africa, freedom for Africa.
Yes, once again, fellow Biafrans, lovers of freedom, men and women of goodwill, conscientious people, wherever you are all over the world, I welcome you this morning. I will say good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and to some of you, good night, depending on your time zone. This is Radio Biafra Extra. We are streaming live through Radio Biafra London. being anchored by the deputy leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Mazi Uche Okafor-Mefo, the man who have assured us that he will not allow the heart of this project to see corruption. Mazi Uche Okafor-Mefo is from Abatete. Abatete is in Anambra State, and Anambra State is Biafra land. He is standing in a deputizing capacity on behalf of our Supreme Leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, the Prince of Afari Ibeku, heir to the throne of Ibeku Kingdom, the one and the only man who stood up to speak for the collective interest of the Biafran people for almost 6 decades now. He is from Afari Ibeku. Afari Ibeku is in Umuahia. Umuahia is in Abia State, and Abia State is Biafra land. And by the special grace of Chukwuka Abiama, I remain George Unibe. I am from Abo. Abo is in Delta State, and Delta State is Biafra land. But of course, we will not proceed as always without acknowledging the Almighty Creator. Chukwuka Abiama is his name. The one who has set our feet upon this path that we must follow, because he is the power that shapes our way in the end, that all men will heal Biafra. Glory and honor be given unto him and him alone. And so I humble myself before him. Anyi na jage mau niziogu ni maramai ihunanya ni nage ubiomage uju anyanya dadio ingwe gimbangwe odi unye dekage ibu wafano mega anyi nini na asina edemao. Once again, I welcome you. We must continue. Our topic this morning is simple. We must save the next generation of Biafrans from Nigeria. Honestly, we soon forget why we are here in the first place. People may not completely agree with us when it comes to the issue of Biafra, but they know the truth. They may not be ready to accept the truth, but they know the truth. We must not forget why we are here in the first place. We're talking about Biafra. A lot of people know the truth. They simply just don't want to accept the truth. But we must not lose focus. We must not forget why we are here. Honestly, you come to think about it, there is nothing I'm going to achieve today that will make meaning to me any longer. Is it going to university to acquire PhD, Harari degree? It doesn't make sense to me any longer. Is it buying Ridge River Sport and then I can show off on Facebook? It doesn't make sense to me any longer. And then people begin to wonder, what exactly are we fighting for? Because in the end of the day, what we stand to defend this day, make no mistake about it, we can never benefit from it any longer. We wake up one day, oh, George Onyibe, you are the president of Biafra land. It's too late. It doesn't make sense to me any longer. Because you schooled in Nigeria and you know you did not go to school. 419 school. In your heart of heart, you don't merit it. As far as you have had contact with Nigeria, you are evil. You know you are evil. Because as a man of God, you can't preach the truth. If not, DSS and EFCC come knocking at your church door the next Sunday service, and you'll be humiliated. And so you see, everything we are doing today is for the next generation of Biafra. And as you are listening this morning, you are Biafra, still growing up, anywhere you are in the world, you must understand that the sacrifice IPOB is making, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, Mazi Uche Mefo, eminent Biafrans are making, it's not for us. It is not for us. It is for you people. The next generation, because you must be delivered from one Nigeria. This is one thing our people soon forget.
No, our leader is going to EU. Let's go quick. Oh. Let's go and take our chance. Oh. You are in a hurry to join IPUB.
May God have mercy upon you. Now, Fana, now, one, among so. Amen.
Oh, our leader is going to address EU. Let's join IPUB quick. Oh. Let's take our chance. Oh.
May God have mercy upon you. Now, Fana, now, one, among so. Amen. But understand, there is nothing left for us any longer. A lot of dreams have been destroyed. A lot of destiny have been destroyed. Dreams and inspiration has been converted or directed to the graveyard. There is no greater honor. There is nothing we desire more than to serve a country that will lay us down in the end of our life with dignity, with respect, that we serve our country. But of course, we will do that with all that is left within us. But then you have Nigeria standing in the way. Nigeria is like the people who created Nigeria. No, you have to reflect back. You have to tell yourself the truth. You have to embrace the truth. You have to accept the truth. You are not yet angry with Nigeria. You do not despise Nigeria. You do not spit on Nigeria. May God have mercy upon you. Amen. May God have mercy upon you.
These are the truth you know already.
The reason why you are still romancing it is best known to you.
If we do not stand up now and defend the next generation from Nigeria, you never know what is coming for them.
But of course, like our father before us, they defended us from one Nigeria. That is why we are here today. Don't let them deceive you.
Oh, Nigeria is going to work. Let's build one Nigeria. It make me sick when I see people say, let's build one new Nigeria. God will punish all of you. A man once said that the race of people, Homo sapiens, is like a complete body of human being. Saudi Arabia could be the hand. Asia could be the head. America could be the chest, the heart. Israel could be the left leg. Africa may be the anus. That is why Donald Trump knows this. That is why I say you are a shithole. Sorry, Nigeria is the anus. That is why I say Nigeria is a shithole. But I need you to understand that British government is the intestine. Akwenfo. No matter how beautiful the food you are putting into your mouth is, the moment you get to the intestine, I don't want to speak big English. The moment you get to the intestine, it turns to shit. Anything that have in contact with British government becomes shit automatically, because in the skeletal system of human being, British government is the intestine. And when I heard this man say this, I say, God, people are still reasoning. The same way is Nigeria. Nigeria is on Toro. Akwenfo. No matter how beautiful you are, no matter how wonderful you are, the moment you get to intestine, you will be converted into shit. That is why we are telling you, all these hopeless politicians from Nigeria, going anywhere in the world, you must stone them shit. This is who they really are. Just take strawberry, ice cream, vanilla, beef, pizza, indomie, puff puff. Just take all those mene you are eating everywhere. Throw it inside your mouth. When it gets to your mouth, it looks very ominous, according to you, Ndoyibo. You now swallow it. It begins to still go mene. Onomatic. The moment you get to your intestine and cross to the anus, it becomes shit, man. Shit. Nothing go contact, have contact with British government or Nigeria and remain the same. This is one truth all of you must accept. No matter how beautiful that food is, once it gets to intestine, getting close to the anus, it becomes shit. Don't pretend that is the destination. Yeah, we are Nigeria. We're going to build new Nigeria. You are a shit. That is your end. That is your fate.
Let's just listen to this clip. Maybe you will understand.
The city of Nigeria began in 1986 when we did the structural adjustment program. When we were persuaded to devalue our currency every week for 32 years. When I went to school, and many of you are here, the naira was $1.50. The naira was almost £1 sterling. They came here, persuaded some brilliant men from Harvard and the World Bank that weekly devaluation was wonderful. 32 years of devaluing your currency until we hit 527. And they were still telling us that the naira was still overvalued. That brought poverty, misery upon us. Then interest rates went to 30%. So nobody could build a factory, start a farm, produce anything, or create jobs. Because every time you bring in a shipload of rice, you also bring in a shipload of unemployment. Because you are transferring your wealth to sustain other economies. Somehow, Nigerians didn't notice it. So we became a nation of importers. Toothpicks. Toothpicks. Each year it cost us $18 million. Importing toothpicks. Tomato pays $400 million. So you talked about tomatoes now. One basket in town now is less than 2,000 naira. The farmers are losing money because the processors don't have enough funds to set up factories. You are going to do tomato paste. It's food-grade stainless steel. You can't just use anything because you'll be putting poison in people's stomachs. Two factories have started off. I believe by the middle of next year, we can comfortably tell importers of tomato paste to stop. But when you do, you make enemies. Even the rice we're trying to reduce, we have enemies, heavy enemies, people who can kill if they have a chance, because you're spoiling their business. And let nobody take it lightly. These guys have seized this country's economy, they've taken us hostage, and they have no intention of giving up, because this is a huge market, a very sweet market, and they have taken control. This regime is unpopular, in part because it is trying to cut down imports and transfer the wealth to our rural people.
But they all lie to you. Well, this regime, these people, it's a lie. Anything that gets close to the intestine turn to shit. Nigeria and creators of Nigeria are shit. Nothing more, nothing less. So whenever you are there, oh, let us build a new Nigeria. God will punish you. Your children shall be leper across the globe. Thunder will fire you. We wake up one day, Marudiko run to London and say, oh, Nigeria have problem. Nigeria have problem. They ask him, tell us what is the problem of Nigeria. He said, too much money, too much money. Britain told him, that is not a problem. We will teach you how to squander it. They came back and built First Act 77 to celebrate idol. First Act 77. From that day, Nigeria has not recovered it today. And then there are some lunatics saying, hey, we're going to build our future Nigeria. God will punish all of you. God will punish all of you. No matter how wonderful the food is, once it gets through your mouth and get to your intestine, it becomes shit. And then they say, oh, we studied in Harvard. We studied in Toronto University. There are mad people everywhere. Let's devalue the currency. It is too high. Devalue it. Most of you don't know that Nigerian Naira is higher than American dollar before in 86. I followed my mother. We bought tear rubber car like we buy tomato today. The same way you go to shop anywhere, shop people, shop right, shop left, shop wrong. I followed my mother, not once, not two times. It should be around 1982. I followed my mother. We went to buy 9-11. I stood there. 9-11 in 1982 was sold for 11,000 naira. We call it a ekpero. They used to tie that bag on their waist, women, with zip. My mother asked him, the name of the man we bought the vehicle from, the wife name, the man, his name is Nkanka. Nkanka. Those of you from Abo, you know who I'm talking of. Yes, this one, how much? He said, 9-11. My mother said, yes. He said, it's 12,000. My mother said, no, it's too cost. It's 11,000. We now start counting 20 naira. Till we count 11,000. We carried motor away as if we went to buy tin tomato. Today, where you buy one Tokumbo motor, you will not hear word again. You are swimming in misery you don't know. Then they say, no, you can't be doing that. To buy motor, you have to kill the whole community. Today, to drive Range Rover Sport now, you have to kill your own community. That's when I look at people like Asare, they are displaying their Range Rover Sport. I spit on all of your grief. Oh, the money is too high. No. Waste it. Devalue it. You are devaluing it. And these same people will come out and tell you they are corruption fighter. British government court is he believes the economic evil. Who is more evil? Bunch of shit everywhere. Anything that come in contact with British government or Nigeria end up becoming a shit. That is why Donald Trump say Nigeria is a shit hole. Drink vanilla, strawberry, pizza. What does those in America eat again? Indomie, okay, donut, puff. Once he touch intestine, he becomes a bunch of shit. Once you have access with Nigeria, you are claiming you are Nigeria. Just snap your poo-poo from the WC, your water system. This is who you are. How long are we going to pretend? But of course, the next generation must be saved from this evil. They came back, Marudiko came back. They start building the first stack they call Jakonde Estate now, or whatever garbage name they call it. It is Nigerian money, stolen from Biafra land, and they start celebrating idol. Today, most of you don't know her. They have shared it among themselves. And when we come here, we tell you, Nigeria must be dismembered. Some people are speaking English. This is a Nigerian criminal telling you that some who claim to go to Harvard, so then you have to devalue Naira. But he become enemy. And so people are still trying to preserve this toilet, this shithole. May God have mercy upon you. Nafa na na wa na moso. Amen. Our people must understand the simple truth. As far as it is Nigeria, there is nothing you can do about it. Nigeria was created to destroy the black race. This is one truth you must understand. Nigeria is the undoing, is the doom of the black race. Well, look at Nigeria. Who is in Nigeria? Ghana, they pursue Nigeria. Cotonou, they pursue Nigeria. Even Sambisa Forest, they pursue Nigeria. Sambisa Forest is chasing Nigeria. And then some people say, you're going to be that one Nigeria. May God have mercy upon you. Na fana na wana moso. Amen. Nigeria is created to destroy the black race. Make no mistake about it. Africa will be free. But until they allow Biafrans to go, Africa will never be free. Because any country or president of the world that say, Nigeria is a black populous country, a very, very black international country, watch them. They are a bunch of shit. These people are evil. They know the truth. Nigeria is a black populous country. The democracy have, they are all a bunch of shit. This is what they are. Nedima Soka Nye Sokwa. But they know what they are doing. With the availability, the existence of one Nigeria, black race will suffer. They don't know who they are. We are fighting for the whole of black race, including Jubilee and his breed. They think it's all about Biafra. Of course, if our calling is to dismember the zoo called Nigeria, and then we are not complaining. Nigeria, you must understand, is the doom of the Biafran, but we are their destiny. The moment you hear Nigeria as a Biafran is your doom, pretend Onyema bring air peace, carry Yoruba people all the way from South Africa down to Nigeria is your doom. Hey, we are former. What is the name of that man? Oh, we are four. We are Niger Delta. We are doing Clark. We are upland, riverland, bottomland. We are the intellectual. We are the governors. Nigeria is your doom. Nigeria is your doom. You are gone. Stop deceiving yourself. Nigeria is intestine, like British government. Anything that enters intestine, the moment you get through the next article, you become emotion. You are a bunch of shit. That very good melody food you put in your mouth, how does it go out through your anus? Utoro. Do not forget that. Nigeria is your doom as a Biafra.
The earlier you rise up and stop Nigeria, the better for all of you. Stop deceiving yourself.
Oh, this our one Nigeria. We're going to walk it. We're going to build one Nigeria. Then they now bring some hopeless animal. They now sing, oh, in Nigeria now, oh, oh, Nigeria now, oh.
But come and sing Nigeria Jaga Jaga. Look at Idris Abdul Karim, who sing Nigerian Jaga Jaga. I was watching his music on YouTube, and he was saying, oh, you know, when I mean Nigerian Jaga Jaga, I don't mean that Nigeria is Jaga Jaga. I'm trying to, you know, he has to sound politically correct. It's not changing Nigerian Jaga Jaga. It is to say that many things has failed. Because they have failed, they are not Jaga Jaga. Now I'm taking it back to the doorstep so you can see everything is Jaga Jaga. Nigeria is your doom. Your doom. You are Yoruba, you are Hausa. Nigeria will destroy all of you. To the earlier you destroy Nigeria, the better for you. Be there shouting because you are stealing 2,000, you are stealing from Biafra land.
Hey, Nigeria is a black populous nation. It's very economically otorotoro. Iwonyoshi.
It's your doom. A time will come, Britain, who created Nigeria, we wish they never associated with Nigeria. Ibunsen, that is what all of you are. Bunch of shit. But Biafrans must understand, no matter how much you want to, oh, they're going to love us. Our leader, Mazenane Kanu, said to you, serve Nigeria as a Biafran and come back in shame. Because Nigeria is your doom. But the good news this morning is that we are their destiny. We are destined to stop them. Yes, they are our doom. But we are their destiny. That is why we may lose all the comfort. That is why we will dear life itself. That is why we will consult heaven and earth. That is why our stand, there is no negotiation. Biafra or Biafra. In life, Biafra. And in death, Biafra. Men and women may rise up to compromise this desire. But men and women will also rise up to make sure it does not die. For in the end, we are reincarnated spirit. And this is our calling. The only reason Nigeria exists is for nothing. Just to steal resources in Biafra land. Anybody you see close to you talking about Nigeria, the unity of Nigeria, the innegotiable of territory, the amalgamity of Nigeria, the international populous black territory zoo, you just shift back from them. You are seeing Satan itself. Lucifer, these are children of Satan. If it's your father, run. Put key in your door when your father knock. Use that, what do they call that hole? Peep your father and say, Daddy, what do you want? Mommy, what do you want? Because only criminal parents support one Nigeria. They are killing you, children. They are killing you. They are evil. They are evil. Anybody who talk about one Nigeria is evil. They exist to steal. Go to coastal region of Biafra land now. British mothership is stealing oil.
And they through BBC and say, oh, you know, it is a very economic. We cannot allow Nigeria to destabilize. If it destabilizes, Africa is going to suffer.
But I tell you, Nigeria is the evil of Africa. You've been saying all this, and we've been telling you no. In Biafra, African died. The day Africans gathered against Biafra, that day they murdered themselves. You murder sleep, you will never go to bed. The evil for Africa has not started. The best thing for all of you is to rally round. You are black American men, yellow Indian men, Chinese, you are a black man. All of you started from this continent. Wake up, free Biafra, and save the next generation of our people.
Yeah, they, oh, it's our one Nigeria. It's going to be this. They are criminal. Your Yoruba pastor say, hey, Jekabadua, let us tell Olorun. Olorun should keep one Nigeria. Their Olorun is evil, and they are evil.
I thought they all have private jet. TB Joshua, his private jet is $100 billion.
Adeboye, private jet, $300 billion.
Odukoya, private jet. Where are all their private jet? They are not bringing Yoruba people. And there is one lunatic who calls himself Igbo man.
He's doing less praising. Hey, Nyema, my name say, is my name Seiko. Hey, Nyema is bringing Nigerian back. And they are not singing national anthem.
Thunder will fire all of you. Not Fana, not one, I'm also army. Don't you know Nigeria is evil? If Nigeria is good, why is Yoruba pastor not sending their private jet to bring people back from Senovibia? Look at all of you, very hopeless people. You are deceiving us, Abi.
You know, let's sound correct. You know, Onyema have tried APCs, okay. You know, who did he bring back? Yoruba people. You are very hopeless. So I spent 20 trillion to bring back Nigeria. You are bringing evil for us. You want us to clap for you. George Onyebi will not clap for you. Because before you have your APC, Adeboye, Kumuye, Oyedepo, all Yoruba pastors have private jets for your information. Even Rogers Okora Usa have. Chibuike Amechi have. I thought they are the one propagandist Nigerianist. Why are they not sending them there? And yet you cannot see that the only reason Nigeria exists is to steal 10% Yoruba. I will say, just say, okay, let's hide under Fulani. We can be still be getting some enchantment. And Fulani are doing like warlord of Africa because they have the backing of the real intestine, British government. The deliberate act of Nigeria, the Nigerian as you see today, their reason of existing is to deliberately emasculate us. You can't tie our road. You can't build schools nor hospital. This is our Nigeria. The only thing you can build in Biafra land is hotel. Hotel for all those uncircumcised animals to come and defile our women. Where is Ibeto? Where is Ibeto's men? Today, now everywhere is Dangote. He said his men stolen from Biafra land to you, 2,000 plus, almost 3,000 now. He take the same cement he's producing in Nigeria and go and sell to people in America for 50 naira. It's our own one, Nigeria. It's our own one, Nigeria. Thunder will fire you. Amen. You people are evil. You people are evil. You begin to think of, let's do Nigeria like this. Let's build. You are evil. The children will curse you one day. Because we are telling you and you are saying, hey, why are we here? Why are we here in the first place? For your information, as a Biafran, Nigeria is deliberately manufactured. It was manufactured in the era. A country that constantly make policies to undermine us as a people in every way imaginable. I have seen Nigeria make law. As we are talking now, there is a lot of bill online now. They are trying to make it. Ruga is still going on there, facing different transformation. And there are people who are saying, no, you know, is it going to be our one Nigeria? We're going to pray to God. It's going to be this one. There are many evil coming on, deliberately undermining us as a people. Let's see if the Yoruba control network, hopeless, useless Nigerian data will let you listen to this.
Nigeria's National Assembly is currently considering the NGO regulation bill for passage. It has gone through the first reading, it's gone through second reading, it's now in committee stage, and later this month, the Committee on NGOs in the House of Representatives in Abuja will be holding a public hearing on the bill. And it's important that you understand what this bill means and its implications for both yourself as a citizen and for the country in general. And let me be clear, this is the most dangerous piece of legislation that has come for consideration in the National Assembly since the return to civil rule in 1999. It covers the activities of every entity and everybody that is not government. And it affects churches, mosques, schools, universities, hospitals, everything, as well as humanitarian operations wherever they are taking place in the country, whether in the northeast or in the southeast or south-south. Whether in the middle belt or in the northwest or southwest, it is totalitarian in its consequences. Now, what does the bill require? Basically, all resources, all funds, everything that are collected or liable to be collected and made available to service communities, individuals in need in this country will be subject to Abuja. Before you can raise funds in your church and your mosque, you have to get Abuja's permission. After you've raised the money, you have to return them to Abuja for Abuja to tell you what to do with them. And when you've done that, only Abuja can help you to do your audits. Nobody can operate anything without clearance from Abuja. It's worse than a totalitarian piece of legislation. For the old mamas and old papas doing isusu in the village, that is revolving credit. Before you do your collections, you come to Abuja for clearance. After you've done your collections, before you share the money or rotate the collections amongst the beneficiaries, you come to Abuja for clearance. Ahmadiyya movement will have to come to Abuja for clearance. Nasfat will come to Abuja to do anything. The mosques that do collections every Friday to support people in their congregations and their communities will all have to account for that money to civil servants who will either tell them what to do with it or collect it and trouser it into their pockets. The churches will be out of business. The mosques will be endangered. This is what the legislators want us to subscribe to.
That is what Nigeria wants you to subscribe to. And some people say, oh, it's Nigeria. These are big, they are passing. Ruga is rugaring everywhere. How many bill are coming to take your land? And we are telling you, hey, let's do one Nigeria. Let's pray to Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is going to help us. How many roads in America did they tie by praying to Jesus Christ? You think Jesus Christ is idle? Hey, let's pray to Muhammad Allah. Let Allah tie our road. How many roads did they tie in Medina, America? Did Allah, did they pray to Allah to tie? Most of you don't know. Well, you see a Muslim with a mark on their forehead, the one they used to tag, knock ground. These are the slave. A real Muslim man, you don't see mark on their forehead. The moment they convert you, all those Biafran claiming to be Muslim, they are the one, the slave are the one you see mark on their forehead. You show the world that you are properly slave. People should respect yourself. Don't let them deceive you. We must save the next generation from Nigeria. They are there to frustrate you as a Biafran. Every law, Ruga, 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 Ruga. You think Ruga is over? They are still Rugaren. But from back door, of course, they are deceiving you with xenophobia. So Ruga can go to next stage in the reading of the zoological Sharia court jurisdiction. Of course, British government practice Sharia law, and we don't expect justice from them. A country that constantly make policies to undermine us as a people, that country is safer. We must fight to defend the next generation of Biafrans. Biafrans, wherever you are all over the world, we will risk life itself. We will dare hell itself. We will do everything to make sure that the truth cannot be hidden. Nigeria is sinful, and so is anybody who supports Nigeria. The greatest atrocity against the black race, whether Indian black, American black, Australian black, Chinese black, Japanese black, African black, hellfire black, heaven black. Nigeria is the evil that is holding all of you down. The earlier the whole blacks rally round and stop Nigeria and the creator of Nigeria, the better for all of us. The better for all of us. But of course, we are not in a hurry. But this is a clarion call to every black man alive today. Rise up and stop Nigeria. For the next generation. How many destiny have they killed? How many dreams have they murdered? Oh God.
Nothing is too unable. As I'm feeling so right, I want to turn the parties so. In a rubber dog style. In a rubber dog style. In a rubber dog style. In a rubber dog style.
As the guard with the balance so majestic. God in the palace, so realistic. Am I good guy at pursuing beer? He said he can't let me out of the race. Oh, man, just to think this way. The way you drive back down. The way you make from blues.
Yes, Biafrans across the world, make no mistake about it. We must save the next generation of Biafrans from Nigeria. The greatest atrocity against humanity. Don't let them deceive you. No matter who they are, protecting the image of one Nigeria, they are evil. They are evil. Our lines, of course, are open. Our WhatsApp line is 070-815-45642. Our WhatsApp line is 070-815-45642. Our direct line is 081-221-52971. Our direct line, once again, is 081-221-52971. Special number for the female is 081-288-58614. Special number for the female is 081-288-58614. Wherever you are, don't let them deceive you. Don't let them tell you all the lies. Nigeria must be destroyed. You have not joined IPOB family. Look for one closer to you and join. Are you there, caller on the line?
Yes, I'm there. Good morning, my Lord. Good morning to all your friends all over the world. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night to some of you. Mechuko Ikeajama bless every IPOB. Mechuko Ikeajama bless everyone. Mechuko Ikeajama continue to guide our leader, our savior, the master, Ohamadike. May Chukwu Kabiyama continue to guide all the DOS, all of them. May Chukwu Kabiyama continue to guide them all. My name is Ginika. I'm calling from Enugu Province, Biafra Land. May Chukwu Kabiyama bless everyone. I just want to say something this morning. You know our reason, our problem is that this our generation, we have never tested freedom. Since we are born as a slave, we grow up having slave mentality, we grow, everything we do it as a slave. We have never tested freedom. We have never tested freedom. That is our problem.
Monitoring
that is
spirit.
Number one mentality.
Monitoring
that,
spirit, you are right. I agree with you.
That is the mentality that our leader has removed from every core member of IPOB. He has given us a long memory and a good sense of reasoning. That is what he did to us. That's why we call him our savior, our leader. Everything, whatever you call your people, we call it to him. Because we need us to understand what is freedom. Freedom. You see, people will see me, they will say, Prime Minister of Biafra, you are going. But they don't understand. They think like Nigeria. Their thoughts are limited to Nigeria. That place they find themselves, that coven of evil spirit, that is the only place they think about. there is nothing again. They can't even think past that coven of the evil to see that freedom is what we needed. Freedom. We don't understand what is freedom. You see, people, they will be moping at you like this. I say, why? How do you make that thing? Hey, you talking like that? Hey! That is it. We you don't understand it. What is freedom.
All. Sister Geneka, you have said it all. In Nigeria, we become so used to suffering. People believe that suffering is part of religious advancement. People believe that we have gotten so used to suffering. They say, God today in a poor man prayer. So die inside poverty because God today.
Yes, you see all these fasting, 40 days, 40 nights. The other pastor fasted and died the other day. Maybe they are very
I understand one Ebony State boy fasted and he said remaining only
ignorant, he don't know what is freedom.
Did they think that Nicholas Tesla fasted to produce electricity DC? Do they think that Harrison Ford fasted to invent those technology? Do they think that Bill Gates, out of fasting and prayer, he did all the heart of a computer?
If a white man fast 2 hours, he will die. I'm telling them, he will die. They eat every time.
All the whole church in the world, all the whole mosque in the world, they are inside Nigeria. In the morning, I called my friend in Abuja, and as I'm talking to my friend, what I'm hearing is, Allah Akbar, whether Allah manufactured Boko Haram terrorists, I don't know. Call your friend in Lagos now. You'll be hearing no look for Jesus, no look for Jesus, no she.
I want to test freedom in my life. That is what I always tell them. I want to test freedom. Freedom. I want to test what is freedom. I've been a slave for all my life. Even everything, slavery, everything. What it's you so eat is slavery. You were talking it yesterday. What you eat is slaving us. Everything. Everything. I want to test freedom. And I will test freedom.
Thank you very much.
May Kadama bless. I pray May Chukwu Kadama keep strengthening you and keep strengthening everyone.
Our God is
thank you for being there for us, all of you. Thank you, sir.
Our people must understand what we do here today is because of the next generation of Biafra. You don't know what is coming for them. Look at Nigeria. Nigeria is intestine. Like the people who create Nigeria. Anything that gets into the intestine, it goes out from their anus and it shit. It will destroy all of you. Black men, human beings are suffering on earth today. It's because of Nigeria.
It's a giant of territorial integrity. They give BB grammar. Our Nigeria is not negotiable. Watch all of them. They are evil.
Are you still there? Call on WhatsApp.
My love, I'm here. I miss you.
Oh, wow. Welcome, my sister.
I miss you. I was calling everybody. Where is my man's the only base? They said you travel. Welcome back, sir. We miss you, sir.
Thank you.
God bless you, sir. God bless our leader. God bless our leader. Man's the owner of the channel. God bless Osheme for. God bless all of you, sir. Sir, mostly you. You know you are from my region. When you are speaking, I will be happy. My heart will be happy, you know. You are from my region, sir. We will conquer all those evil that is here where Biafra come. We need this Biafra. We need our freedom. You see, we are not tested freedom. And our next generation, we are not planning anything for them. They are not using us. When Nigeria, I have talked to some Yoruba and Edo. Let them just get up now. Yoruba, start your own Oduduwa Republic. Edo people, start your own. If you want to join Biafra, join or go and join Oduduwa. Don't disturb us.
They don't need.
Don't bring barrier to rock.
In Edo State, we know our people. We know Yoruba blood. We know everybody. I'm from Bende State. We know everybody. So they can be doing what they want to do. And they know the truth already. We
they
are the one
to
who
come and be bringing barrier to us when we are already near our freedom. They will come here and be saying, shouting one Nigeria, one which useless one Nigeria. If you want to buy soap, you first of all, first pay part to Abuja. You want to shit, take paper to Abuja. You want to do this, Abuja. You want to do that, Abuja. Is it that the rest people
but,
are doing?
But who is in that Abuja or Chinama? One cattle uh-huh. area is in Abuja. Chief Justice of Nigeria uh-huh. is driving plane. Plane that carry Jubilee to Japan. He's driving plane. Mm-hmm. Chief Justice of Nigeria. Mm-hmm. Mad people. Mm-hmm. Everyone say this is one Nigeria. Let's give
it. They don't use their sense. They come up with disturbing somebody here. It's electoral. Which useless it's electoral. What do you people know? You know nothing. Because you don't know how the country, other country operates. So you don't need to come and be confusing us. We are here to tell you people what you want to hear. Man's the only bit. God, we bless you. You are my love. And people don't get there where I feel married you, Jay. You feel married me, Jay. No problem. Because you give them what they want to hear. You don't look at their face. Those useless people, one Nigeria. Nigeria have not do anything for you guys. But I say one Nigeria. You have all resources. Mazi, they just found gold now in those states. Ugo, Ugoneki, Ugoni Okoriome, Ugo, different Ugo. They just find gold. I go stupid
food. Nigeria is the deposit of heaven on earth. But yes. The evil men know they want to keep it to themselves.
Yes. Tell people we just do your thank God. Tell people we just don't share it.
Do you know that in Abudu? Do you know that in Abudu there is no species of monkey or chimpanzee that is not in Abudu?
Okay.
These are the things they will tell you. And then our people are going to Sambisa or Cambodia to look at chimpanzee.
I beg. We have everything. We are suffering. Thank you. God will bless you, sir. God will bless you. God will bless you. Thank we don't you. Know. Yeah, we have people that will talk to these people. Manzi, continue. Thank we will be back to you. Yeah, your children. God bless you, sir.
Dear France, across the globe, must understand. Destroy Nigerian will be the greatest pride for our children. Don't mind them. You are Wosa, you are Fulani, you are Yoruba. One Nigerian don't save you. You are Yoruba, you remain 10%. You are Wosa, you remain slave to Fulani. You are Fulani, you remain slave to British government. You are British government, you remain a curse to the world. Create one Nigeria, amalgamation of one Nigeria, in territorial integrity, you are all evil. The undoing of the black race is Nigeria. We must save the next generation from Nigeria.
Is you know is in Nigeria this is our one Nigeria is innegotiable it is a negotiable and a negotiable
Yoshi. Are you there caller on WhatsApp?
Good morning, Mazonibe.
Good morning, my brother. Go ahead.
Welcome back. Fellow Biafrans, France, my name is Simon Ayanogo. Calling from Amelia, Spain. I just want to chip in some of your topic and the situation we find ourselves in that so-called Nigeria. Our people, like last caller said, the people they never tested what they call freedom and what it means to live without stress, problem of light, problem of road, problem of healthcare ever before. So I want to ask every one of you, be you rich man, be you poor man, any class you are, asking what is Nigeria? What is one Nigeria? What is Nigeria? Most of us, 75% of 80% of those that call themselves Nigeria have never benefited in anything from Nigeria. If it is not from your family, if it is not from your friend, if it is not from your heart struggling, nobody knows you. Only thing you benefit there is that slave tag, Nigerian passport, you suffer to get. That anywhere you presented it, no road for you. So our brothers and sisters, it doesn't matter your tribe, Yoruba, Arewa, Fulani, or anything. Nigeria is just like smoke. It doesn't exist. A country.
You are putting on black skin. The cause of your problem is Nigeria. It's a simple truth.
They don't know.
We can't negotiate.
They don't know.
Black India, Black America, Black Australia, Black Hellfire,
Nigeria Black is the problem.
If you are putting on black skin, Nigeria is your problem. One day you will understand why we must make sure Nigeria is obliterated from the face of the planet Earth. Only criminals and looters say talk about one Nigeria. You see anybody say, oh, we're building one Nigeria. Forget about who they are. They can be Reverend Father or Imam or Angel Michael. Anybody supporting one Nigeria, I say, for You have seen the evil in personification.
A country that paid money for the suffering of its own people. Nigeria will spend billion telling other countries all over the world to punish them, to enslave them, to imprison them, to deport them.
Nigerian government supposedly are the only one who travel around the world. They begin to say, my people are indisciplined, my people are useless, my people are hopeless. Was that not what Buhari was doing before he died and taking over from Jubri? Buhari was my people are lunatic, my people are mad, my people are this one. Now Jubri now is even paying money to kill my people. Ndiara.
So, my brothers and sisters, and I want to use this opportunity to call this all these cowards. Because if you behave like one of them, we call you names. Yoruba activists, human rights, freedom fighters that people look for. Because activism, they started it earlier. I must say this, Yorubas. But now, where are you guys? So it's the same thing you people allowed to happen in 1992/93 during the time of Abiola. So if there is no Radio Biafra, Sowore will be killed, if you guys don't know. And if you people turn back to betray Sowore or betray anybody fighting for separation of to kill that name, Nigeria, to kill, to set his people free, if you people don't stand up, like as our leader have said it, you people will pay for it. It's time to wake up. Let us free ourselves now. This is the time. It's happening all over the world. There is crisis in what we are doing because they know we still exist. This is time to free our Nigeria, to free ourselves from this shackle of Nigeria. Nigeria don't exist. It's 419.
Thank you very much, Biafra. We must continue. Make no mistake about it. Are you there, caller on the line?
Hello?
Yes, good morning from here.
Good morning,
man. Your voice seems to be very, very low. I would appreciate it if you can speak up. Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
I'm calling from Abba.
Go ahead, please.
Good morning. I want to just go grab them.
Your complaint is noted. Go ahead, please.
Okay, I want to thank you, Kadiaman, for all you, Mazi Nandekana, for the wonderful job you did for us. I want to thank you, Mazi George Lee, for the wonderful work you did for us. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Colin, what's up? Are you there?
Yes, I am here, my Honorable Rep. Umachineke.
Good morning.
Umachikuoko Kabiama. Good afternoon from here. My name still remains Ezekwem Chechi. I'm from Amuro Oki Province, Biafra Land. My Rep, we thank Uoko Kabiama for your life, just like so many of our members have expressed their enthusiasm towards your life, towards your health, towards your absence for a couple of days. Now we have not heard from you. We were so worried. What is really wrong? What is really going on in Biafra land? What is really happening to one of our own? What is really happening to the tiger himself after our leader, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, my deputy, and other head of Directorate of State, those that represent all those IPOP hardcore all over the globe, working assiduously to make sure that we get our freedom. My Rev, I thank God for your life that you are back again and back more stronger. Whatever thing that might be the problem, the zoo will not succeed. We must conquer them. We have already conquered them already because they don't know where to run to anymore. We always be victorious. We thank God for your life. My brother, actually, the topic you said yesterday, the topic you raised again this morning, all of the topics have been so marvelous, have been so wonderful, as you always be, because you know what to do and know how to do it the best. Actually, as I'm listening to you this early morning, a lot of things has went wrong in that contraption called Nigeria, which if we don't do anything humanly and the livingly possible, the way they put it, oh God, we will not have any atom of hope upon the surface of this earth as we are talking. Because only the dismemberment of this contraption, the demon contraption called Nigeria, is the only thing that will give us hope. Just imagine, just 1986 or just 80 something, 30 something years ago, we are better than all this, country, American dollar or British sterling pounds. Our money is have more value, heavier than them. But look at us today. Look at us today. We cannot boast of anything. The naira is really rubbish. They say it's a devaluation of currency. That's what will make them to be better. But are we better now?
My brother, of course nothing, nothing makes me go more jagger.
To hear intellectuals saying, you see, let's build one future Nigeria. We're building new Nigeria.
You are building new criminal. You are evil. They are evil. They wake up, they say, oh, Nigeria, you are too rich. You have to devaluate your currency. We now start devaluating it. So then we did all go more than Nigeria. They did. Most people don't know the essence of First Tax 77. Nigerians so rich, so stupid, so hopeless that they now gather the whole world. Please come to Nigeria, let's celebrate idol. Your pastors don't teach you this. Don't tell the whole world gathered in Nigeria to squander our wealth and worship the whole equation and the ocean and the armor. Go to First Tax now. Most building belong to Yoruba, 10% Jack on the estate in the Oshi. These are resources stolen from Biafra land. And there is a pig inside swamp there. Tell me, one Nigeria is not negotiable. Now, one Nigeria must be destroyed if we want our children to survive.
We've not done the obituary.
It is dead already. We must do the way keeping. We must do the obituary. That is the reason why we are here. It's dead already. Everybody
it has
that.
To.
We have not done the God, because... and obituary. The Oshi.
My goodness me, Nigeria must be this way because with the existence of that entity, we are doomed forever. We are doomed forever. No hope for us with the existence of that entity. Just imagine, years ago, look at us, what is happening. And then what marvels me a lot is that in that cult contraption, they do fasting and prayer more than any word. They do, we that live in diaspora, we that live in the overseas, we that live with the so-called white people. These people will not live their job, who will not live whatever they are doing. And it's not that it's not mean that you will not go to church and worship God. But these people will tell me they will not stop whatever thing they are doing. Somebody will be engaged on this, somebody will engage in night walk, somebody will engage in afternoon walk, somebody will engage in morning walk. Tell me the time you have to be going to the church and doing this and doing that. I could remember this Ed Buhari, early 2016. This man went and met David Cameron in United Kingdom. And talking rubbish about Nigeria.
He went to meet the masters. The colonial master.
My goodness me.
Rola Lady Dan and Margaret Thatcher, Ngobati and Peter Blota, Theresa May and alt-right, including David Cameron. They want to be the black master. They want to be the black master. Akwenfo.
My goodness.
Thank you very much, my brother.
My brother, God bless you. Anybody that is praying for the unity of Nigeria.
May their children be like one Nigeria. May their family be like one Nigeria. If they fail to say, you say, may Amadio have visited them.
Thank you. God bless you.
Anybody. Oh, let's be like one Nigeria. Let's be future Nigeria. May your family be like future Nigeria. Your children like one Nigeria. If you don't say, you say, Amadioha will visit you.
When I say thunder fire you, invariably I'm saying Amadioha will visit you. Ndiyoshi. Ndiyohi. We join Billy Channel.
You know, you're going to build integrity.
Now the world know. Anybody conversing, projecting the image of Nigeria, it's our one lovely Nigeria. These are criminal. Nigeria is jaga jaga. Nigeria is evil. Nigeria must be destroyed. Nothing more, nothing less. Are you there? Call on WhatsApp. Are you there?
Yes, my hello.
Yes, go ahead.
Are you talking to me, sir?
Of course, I'm talking to you. Call on WhatsApp. Go ahead.
Okay.
Please.
Okay, my lord. Good morning, sir. Good morning, dear friends. Good morning, friends of dear friends all over the world. This is Mazi BK from Paris, sir. My comrade, I'm very, very happy today to hear your voice, honestly, and was very, very happy. Believe in me, may God, Chukwu Okikeama, bless you and guide you and your family. My Lord, today is a very happiest day since almost 3 or 4 days now I never heard from you. And this topic you bring today makes me to, that is, it gives me a lot of joy. Those people that call One Nigeria, I want to ask them one, only one question. I want to ask them, One Nigeria, why are you saying One Nigeria? My Lord, today I'm about 44 years. If I live in Nigeria, my daughter here is 13 years. I was in Nigeria before I start shouting, up NEPA, up NEPA. Any day they bring light, we shout up NEPA. My Lord, today, could you believe, if I was Nigeria, my daughter was still shouting up NEPA in the name of One Nigeria. My Lord, all those people that are saying One Nigeria, God will punish all of them, because they will still continue shouting up NEPA every day. They wake up in the morning, they shout up NEPA. My Lord, they know that only Biafra people can deliver this country. It's only Biafra people. Why? Because we are all over the world. We like a freedom. Freedom is our DNA. We cannot do without a freedom. That's why in early 70s, Ojukwu noticed this and tried to separate us, because we are not a people that they conquered. But today, we will say no for that thing. There is no one Nigeria. No one Nigeria. Nigeria have not helped us anymore. Nigeria have not helped us in today. Nigeria will not help us tomorrow. It's only Biafrans. They are seeing it. Yoruba will not succumb, because they know that if they succumb, they will be in last level of the everything they are looking for. That's why they know it. My Lord, I say, may Chukwu Okikeama bless you. Keep on pulling the ball. Let the ball roll, my Lord. May God bless you. We are moving forward. No going back. Biafra must come, and Biafra is here with us.
And
God bless you, my Lord.
And you
God
too.
Bless you.
Yes, are you there, caller on the line? Monitoring spirit. Go ahead, please. Hey.
Happy New Year. I have felt your accent so much. I love you. You are back again. You continue to the struggle for Biafra restoration. It is either Biafra or Biafra. Or either Biafra or death. No two ways about it. It is either Biafra or death. Our radio is not talking. Adia Mama. They do them for we go the reggae. I'm going to speak to you, my day before yesterday. You are resolute, a good man. I am solidly behind you. Biafra, over the more we're going to have for Biafra, my director. I got my head, Biafra, there is no one. We will know. We will know our hotel. That is just the truth. We are Biafra. Trump, listen, my leader has gone to the EU. He says it is either Biafra or death. We must restore Biafra. Madrid, please, every Biafra story over the world. My name is Dr. Chikwe Chikosa. Umuwa produce Biafra land. Almost short in the true way, I can't bear the real way as you go one go. There is nothing in life that will make us not to restore Biafra. If Biafra is by violence, look at what they are doing in South Africa. Look at all the effort our leader has been doing just for one sec, Biafra. Our identity in this world, our identity in this world. And the people don't want us to stand into our identity. What did we do? Our destiny is our destiny. We want to control our destiny by our hands. All forms and culture. Nigeria is their property. Biafra is our nation. And we must restore Biafra. I appreciate my coordinator, Majesty Chairman. He is great to me. The support of Biafra continues to bless you and your descendants. And my deputy, Mona Tinsho. The support of Biafra continues to bless you, people. From eternity to eternity, we must restore Biafra. It is either Biafra or death. Holy, holy, holy.
We must continue.
The whole world power, whatever you people like, do. If you want to use the life of Biafra as finance, scientific experiment.
No problem.
In our harvest, our kidney and others are killing us every day by day. We are suffering. Do you know why? Do you know how I am suffering? I am personally. You know, I'm suffering. At the moment, we want to get Biafra. We are ready to get Biafra by violence.
We must continue. Colin, what's up? Are you there?
The fearless lion with no limits.
My brother, good morning from here. Go ahead, please.
I bless you. Strengthen you. No weapon fashioned against you shall ever prosper, because it will cook on them Biafra. I listen to you every morning. All the time you are on, I listen to you. My dear brother, my name is Ike Ike. Maximum respect to our leader, Mazen Nandekano. Maximum respect to the deputy leader, Uche Mefo, the person I named Wokike, Obu Wokike. Look, if Biafrans know the efforts these guys are making to ensure the realization of Biafra, nobody will panic. Biafra is just around the corner. The Queen of England wants to speak to our leader. The whole world wants to speak to our leader. They want to know our leader. This is a man endowed by God. This project is endowed by God. The state that the zoo is now is Emma. When you cut off the head of the chicken, it will be flapping all over the place. The zoo is finished. The zoo is absolutely finished. And the latest delivery of injustice by the court investigating election malpractices of the last election, the world has cringed. Sebi, a Yoruba man is now saying that this man in Aso Rock is not Buhari. Who is in Aso Rock? And when our leader calls Nigeria the zoo, people are asking him, why are you calling Nigeria the zoo? A place where you have doctors, PhDs, professionals, and they don't know that the person ruling them is not Buhari. If you replace any international prime minister now, say somebody else is personating them, those countries.
Of course, Zoo Epileptic Network, as always. But then, we've come to the end of this morning programs, and our people must understand, it is Biafra or Biafra. no two ways about it. We will no longer sing the Lord's song on a strange land. We want to go home. We want to go home. We want to go home. We want to go home.
Rivers of Babylon, there we sat down, there we wept, when we remembered Zion. By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down, there we wept, when we remembered.
The rivers of